architects, her work focuses on urban design concepts into creating vibrant public realms. Her firm, Oasis Designs Inc, is engaged in various projects ranging from planning new TOD townships, smart cities, streetscapes, public landscapes, plazas, in addition to the regular private commissions. These award-winning firm specializes in creating vibrant ecological urban spaces to make our cities better. Kindly take the dais, ma'am.
Hello, everybody. First of all, I would like to thank BVCOA for giving me this opportunity to come and speak in front of you people. And especially I would like to thank Ritu Deshmukh and Smita, who really sought me. I was not sure that whether I will be able to come or Akash or somebody else from my office. So, and just a little correction, my firm's name is Oasis Designs Inc, not Incorporation. Yeah. So today I'll be talking about human-centric design, which was the topic, I guess, of this conference. So the city that we live in, what are the things that we have? What are the uses? We have housing, we have institutes, we have schools, hospitals, whatever the people of the city need, it's there in the city. So for them to work, for entertainment, for them to live. Now, does that define the city, or does the open space and the interrelationship of the open space and the building, that defines the city? How the open space interacts with the city and the built form, that is what the image of the city is. So if we just look at the open space requirement in our city, 50% of the population right now is around living in our cities. And it's said that by 2050, it'll be 70%. So the environment in the cities that we live in, walk through, go to, it shapes us as people. So the presence or absence of open spaces affects us psychologically. It's a very important factor. All the emotions that we have, happiness, stress, anxiousness, is pegged on the space that we have in our city. So the requirement of open space in the city, as per WHO standard, is around 9 square meter per person. For a city like Mumbai, it is 1 square meters, and maybe in the next master plan, it's supposed to be 3 square meters per person. So, and the best cities of the world have much more open space given. So what constitutes open spaces? Basically, the parks, gardens, playgrounds, everything which is outside the building is the open space. But most of our cities basically are cut up in small pockets or large pockets with these arterial roads, and those kind of define a colony in a city, and the open space within that is basically which is accessible for the people. So there's a very famous saying that we should either have highway-less cities or city-less highways. So if you go to continent like Europe, most of the cities don't have very wide roads, and most of the connectors between cities, they don't have any population living around them. But in places like America, and even in India, we follow America more. So we have large arterial roads cutting across through our cities. So apart from the quantity of open space, even the quality of open space is important. Like what is the available open space? And if we look at all the old cities, if we just look at the livability aspect, old cities, the grain and the typology and the quality, is much better for people to live in. So what are the things that, make it more livable? Basically, it's the scale, it's the grain, it's accessible, and they are very unique also. So if you look at the identity of the city, what defines it is the planning grain, the heritage scale, response to natural features and the character, and all of their interrelationship with each other kind of define the identity of a city. So if we look at Mumbai, so you do have the heritage layer, which is very strong. But Mumbai is also looked at because of its promenades and Carter Road, Marine Drive, and also the Mumbai Railway is also a very strong identity of the city. Similarly for Delhi, the heritage is also a very important factor. The greenery of Delhi is widely liked by people, and even the contemporary elements like the metro, etc. But now, of late, Delhi's identity is kind of changing because of the pollution aspect. And why it has happened, maybe because of our planning, decisions that we have taken over the years, where we have concentrated more on creating car-centric infrastructure instead of people-centric infrastructure. So, so that's what, like, this is what I think about cities. So what is the energy in the city? What constitutes it? The people, the sound, the visual diversity, the movement in the city. So what are the emotions that create the negative energy in a city? Anger, confusion, anxiety, stress. And what are the things that cause it? Like traffic, noise, pollution, haphazard parking, no place to walk properly, inadequate trees, unsafe neighborhoods, high boundary walls, less lighting, encroachments. So these are the things that causes all the, negative energy. But when we think about positive energy in a city, we think about green spaces, we think about trees, we think about organized walkways. So we have to look at the cities from the point of view of people. What would people like to see instead of, there was this talk I had attended by this lady called Jeanette Sadiq Khan. She was the former transport commissioner of New York. She said that I had an epiphany that if an alien came to our world, they would think that we worship the cars. So it looks like we make our cities for the cars. We don't make it for the people. So how do we make that energy shift? So there is this system of this thing, Tai Chi and Qigong, in which they say that everything is about energy. So if we want to make an energy shift, how do we make it happen? So if we think of our roads as roads, or if we think of our roads as streets, so the roads are only about traffic, but the streets are all inclusive. So we have our cars, of course, our traffic, we have people, we have activities. So this is the shift we would like in our cities to happen. So when we say that, no, it's not going to happen in India, we've got too many people and whatever. So if we look at the density, there are more denser cities than our cities in India. Of course, Indian cities are also very dense, but there are other dense. But they have managed to have better planning. So what we have done is planned more for the private vehicle infra. But if you plan with the buses or trains or other mobility choices, then you can have better cities. So coming to the mobility choices, so if we look at transit is mass transit like metro and you know, trains and all. So if we concentrate everything around the transit, all your live, work, play. So like, you know, you will have a lesser requirement of movement of people, you know, in your vehicles and all. So that we have to look at. So where are the open spaces? The open spaces can be as big as railway station precincts. It can be as small as a parklet. It can be a street corner. So like each and every space in the city is a potential open space, and we have enough of it. We just have to recognize it, and we obviously have to look at the ownership. If it's a government land, of course it can be changed into a positive open space. Even in the colonies, we have a lot of private parking. People take over land to, you know, build their own parking lots and everything. So this is a project that we are right now doing in Delhi. So this is the space which is there. So we can, you know, kind of turn it around if we want. And there is no shortage of fund in, you know, infrastructure projects. But we have been, you know, using those funds in the wrong direction, basically. So coming to some of the projects that we have done, and we have been working on the urban realm for quite some time. So basically what we have looked at projects and spaces, we have tried to identify the potential and then come up with a solution. So and we also have understood that we cannot look at one project. We have to look at the whole you know, space holistically. So there are many layers that come in. So the water layer, the mobility layer. So the kind of projects also changes according to that. So we have been working on projects, guidelines, and policy interventions. The problems that we have faced is in a city like Delhi, there's like major multiplicity of agencies. So many ULBs working together or not working together. So the city is kind of in silos. And there's a major tug of war in terms of what is the, you know, road space kam kar rahe ho or whatever. So what we have to do is debate with these people, negotiate, phase our projects accordingly, and have flexibility to change our projects. We can't be like, you know. So, and we have looked at people-centric designs. So the first project I would like to share with you is in Ahmedabad. So again, Ahmedabad is known for its heritage, its open spaces, but it's also known for its Sabarmati riverfront. Now, we have to understand that Sabarmati riverfront is a project which has a lot of negatives, but it also has a lot of positives. So the negative is that they've got this like very high boundary wall and whatever, that huge 7-meter wall, and they've not kind of changed it or whatever. So it's like too much of concrete and all. So when we were given this project, we won it through a competition. So this was the site, how it was there. And what happened was that from the site, you could not see the river. So what we did was, and then they said that we are not going to cut the wall even an inch. So what we did was we just tweaked the section in such a way so that we had a two-level promenade and you could actually see the river. And from everywhere you could see the river. And of course it was a nice normal park in the city. And the Chinese president was also hosted here. And what we like is that people love the park, and it is also part of the positive identity of the Sabarmati riverfront. Another project on the riverfront, so the two parks on the riverfront has been done by us. We have not done the riverfront, HCP has done it. We have just done those two parks. So again, this had a major problem that the road level was out here. So this was the road, there was a, like a big wall. and then there was this wall. So, and the site was below. So what? So if you are standing inside, you'll have no visibility towards the river, and and from the outside, it looked like this, and it was right next to Ellis Bridge. So what we did is, in terms of how to negotiate the levels and everything, for the entry, we just had a ramp, which would lead you kind of to the upper level. And so this ramp, in fact, became kind of a feature element for the entry. And once you come up, then we again got the landscape depressed so that you didn't have to have too much of filling. So that became like a prospect view for your, the flower valley or whatever. Again, after that, we just had a little higher space. So the edge of the park was at a higher level so that you could view the river as well as the landscape inside. And again, the inner portion was depressed. And the other entry, we kind of designed it in such a way so that the entry happens from the center, and this is like the edge, and the food court is tucked within it. So this is the food court on the upper level. But both these parks were gated parks. But for us, we feel that our cities need ungated public spaces. So our trust with ungated public spaces happened way back in the early 2000s when we got the first project in NDMC area in Delhi called the Malcha Market. So what was happening is, again, there were like parking right in front of the market, and then we made it into a public space. And thereafter, we worked on some projects during the Commonwealth street design projects. So there we got some issues right, like universal accessibility, reducing the height of the curbs and movement of the pedestrian at one level, and let the cars go up and down. And we created some public open spaces also. But those were little positives what happened at different projects. But in Pune, we did this pilot project where everything kind of came together. So we got a package of the Deccan area in Pune. I don't know if you guys are aware of it or not. So this Deccan area is, I think, the most vibrant area in the city. So it has got FC Road, JM Road, and everything. So this was JM Road, and this was my first landing, in a way, on JM Road. And when I saw the street, I did not see the chaos. I just saw the trees. So you just have to look at the positive. And such beautiful trees out here. But of course, there was this too much of tar and no movement, clear movement for the pedestrian and all. So this was the rain tree, which was like just too pretty. And as I told you, the JM FC Road has got a lot of young vibe. So there's the FC College, COEP, Agriculture College. So a lot of young people are around this whole area. So the issues that we faced was, the first one was that the width of the road as per the DP was 36 meters. And but earlier it was 30. So that 3 meter space was an issue, because that was still private land, and those people who had used the TDR would be able to will get the land, but most of the time this area was parking. So the first thing that we did in a public project like this, which is a moving road, is how what as a sample stretch that you take. So you have to take the first low hanging fruit, you can say. So we have this. We had this place in front of Sambhaji Garden. So this was how it looked like. So it had parking and it had a small walkway, but the ownership was not there. This was PMC land, so we did not have any issue with the ownership. So what we did was that this was the view. So what there was a multi-level parking lot here. So we told the authorities, idhar to multi-level parking lot hai. So we just shift the parking there. There's no point of putting the parking here. So we got this entire space as a public space. So then we divided the whole space into cycle track, a multi-utility zone, a walkway, and whatever. So this is how it looked like. And all the elements that were used was taken from the existing elements. For example, the Sambhaji Garden wall had a grill. So the grill element, kind of transformed into a pergola. And then even the seaters coming out of this wall, we just had it painted red so that it looked at as an extension of the wall itself. So this is how it looks like. So this place is always full. So what happened, as soon as we made the space, so initially there was a lot of negative publicity, ki ye road chota kar rahe hain, ye kar rahe hain, wo kar rahe hain. And I don't know, why do we need so much of space for the pedestrian and it's going to be misused and whatever. But anybody who goes there, so like people loved it. So there was like a huge energy shift. This is where I found that there can be an energy shift to a people-centric place. So this is how it looks like. So you never find this place empty. In fact, very few people are inside the garden in comparison to what people are outside. So there is this space in at the end of this Sambhaji, this garden area. It's called the Nukkad. So we made it because there was a chai wala here. So we thought it'll be good for some people to come and sit with their chai and everything. So, but the PMC removed the vendors. Anyway, so still this place is really used, and we got two chess tables. So people, this was taken at 10:30 at night. People were playing chess at 10:30. The students come and do their craft workshops here. The birthday parties are celebrated here. Now, when you do the street design, when you get the geometrics in place, then you get a lot of space. So that's what I was saying, that you do, you have to find place for people instead of just giving it away for free to the cars. So this is another junction. So this was how it was. This was still happening, the work, another junction. So these are some before afters. So this was before, after. This was the walk, so-called walkway. So now it's become like this. So as I told you earlier, the problem with the vendor, what happened is that we were not very happy that the PMC decided that the vendors be removed from this whole redesigned space. So so this was the area before at near the Bal Gandhar junction. Where earlier boundary wall was like this. Suddenly, when it was kind of redesigned, I saw a lot of these, vendor kind of stalls here, but in one line. So that 3 meter space that was still the private property land, so these private people started having those vendor people here. So it kind of themselves, they organized the space. So this is that issue. And even the other private players came with this thing called JM Corner, where all the vendors were incorporated in the design. But this is done by the private people. Now, government, if they can, like you have in Singapore, the hawker centers and everything. So it'll be great if we, could incorporate vendors in an organized way. And the autos obviously came. And then these are the different activities. The mother teaching her kids, reading a book, reading newspaper, and these two ladies talking, skating. This is Jeanette Sadiq Khan on the JM Road stretch. Some of the other street designs that we are doing, so for us, it's very important that it's not just one little project. We need the whole a larger scale influence that should happen. So some roads that we are doing in Delhi, that's happening. Again, the same thing, incorporating good practices. In NDMC area also, we are doing it. Now, in NDMC area, what happened was that we got very important streets. If everybody knows around CP, these are the streets that we are doing. So we thought we'll do cycle track, footpath, but we later realized the authorities wanted those little things to happen. So the first park that we made out here, this is the second park. Phir humne socha ki park hi banate rahenge. We were more interested in the ungated public space. So we came up with this idea ki let's have high intervention zone, medium intervention and low interventions. And then we have these, around the metro stations, we have these catalysts which will kind of spur the whole system of nice open space of the city. So in Janpath, there are these two pockets which have parking. So, and there was available parking in between the buildings. So we just said, ki aap parking peeche kar do, saamne ka road. Matlab, why should, see the whole idea is parking is not a thing to for us to see. It, maybe it's important, but we should just put parking behind buildings. So these are the some before afters. So this project is in the tender stage. Again, Mandi House, the whole area with some. We are working on in another city, Coimbatore, on a smart city development where we are creating a continuous NMT track all along the eight lakes. Now, Coimbatore does not have anything else. It just has these lovely eight lakes and they have not valued it. So I think this whole project will create that value for the city. So we are looking at this project holistically where we are looking at the water, we are looking at public open space, treatment of the wastewater which is coming into the drain. So this is how the Bandh right now looks at. So from the road also the visibility of the lake is not there. So we are removing the Bandh. We are working with hydrologists and like it's not that we are doing it all on our own. So we don't want to get wrong in terms of, you know, the hydrology design and all. So this is the public space. In Chennai, there are certain projects that we start off with and maybe then it's taken up by other people. Like this is a first bus only street with ITDP that we did way back. Now it's being taken as a smart city project, but now being done by somebody else. This we did with CRCI for the Amritsar Hriday project, in which we looked at the different zones around the walled city. But now it's been done by somebody else. Now this is some of the contributions that we've made in terms of the guidelines. This is a street design guideline for UTPEC. The stormwater, sustainable stormwater management guideline for IRC as well as UTPEC. This was a project in which the heart of the project was community participation, which we did with Professor Ashok Lal. It was called Aapki Sadak. It was very interesting because we interacted with the community and came up with some solutions. So whatever I've shown you till now are basically pilot projects. Now how to make this kind of have a wider reach? So we did this project with UTPEC again, the Karkaduma TOD planning. So currently we are doing making these some codes for planning for the Mumbai Suburban Rail Corridor, which is from Virar to Panvel. So what we did was looking at all the aspects of the station at a larger macro level. We created these place types which, you know, then can be taken up and looked at in more detail. And of course, we looked at all the green and the blue layers. And then we decided on the character zone. So there were three stations which we had to do in detail, like so maybe the station precinct, high street, nature oriented, village precinct. So there were a lot of these Gothans. I think you guys must be familiar with it. So we incorporated the Gothans in our design also. So all the the roads and the cross connections were looked at, the land parcels which were available were looked at, the green network, the built. So there were some existing development like the Lodha. So how do we connect the station as well as that? So finally we came up with the policy which looked like this, but it was informed by all the studies that we had done. So whenever somebody is kind of taking up a particular project in the zone, they will have to refer to the policy. Currently, we are working on a toolkit for the Indian Railways is doing the station precinct and the station area development for 8,000 stations around the country. They're like the big thing. So many architects are engaged, but they don't know a lot of things. So then we are also helping out in that. So finally, I'll end with one project which is kind of close to our heart. So this was a project which many years ago we came to in Delhi. There was this issue of the metro coming in, and the metro was world class, but the area around was absolutely chaotic. So this is how it looked like. So we were told ki, okay, you make a case of a metro station. So Chhatarpur metro station was very close to our office. So we decided, theek hai, we'll take it up. So after that, we, UTPEC made a checklist, and then 70 stations were given to different firms, and we also did a few. And we made area-based plans, and then certain areas we looked at could be turned into TOD projects. So this is the few days back I had gone and clicked pictures of some of the stations that we had done. So the MMI was kind of sorted, but what was happening is that these spaces were there, but in a way there were no value addition to the spaces. You know, like huge spaces around the metro station. So coming back to Chhatarpur, now Chhatarpur we are doing the detailed design. So we are looking at all the aspects right till the end of the project. The other MMI projects was only till the planning stage. So this is how the Chhatarpur station was, and we made the proposal. So the whole parking would be shifted to a parking lot which is behind, and the whole face of the station would have a pedestrian space. So we organized the spaces around. We also organized the multimodal integration, all where your autos will come, Grameen Seva and everything. So this is an important project in terms of phasing. So there was this Maruti showroom in under the station. So they had these cars, a lot, right in front of the entry. And there was another parking lot here. So, and there was a parking lot which was available there. So we said, okay, you shift the Maruti guys here as of now. And there was this bike parking here. So we said, okay, shift the bike parking here. And then shift the rest of the parking here, the metro parking and all. Then after we shifted the Maruti parking here, we divided this whole space into different, you know, zones, ki bike parking, Maruti parking, as well as normal car parking. And so we got this whole area as a public open space. So this, right now the work is still going on. So this is the current space. And what we are doing is we are not just planning. So we are doing the whole landscape design, where looking at trees, activity seats, lighting, everything. So this is how it looks like. And these are the spaces eventually. So primarily green space, primarily plaza space. And so I end with this quote by Fred Kent: if you want to plan cities for cars and traffic, you'll get cars and traffic. If you want to plan for people and places, you will get people and places. Thank you.